院日间照顾整合中心的一个主任哈。那我们同时在这边可以看到这样的一个文编呢，其实是由我们新竹的。
You can see the poster actually is prepared by the team from 高雄 and from 台北。
那从这里当下的，我们来看一看这些。
Let's hear some story about Zhang Xinling. So you can see a few elders that doing some exercise on the daycare center. I'm already 90 years old and trying some exercise to.Make sure they are long. It's kind of fun over here. This is Zhang Xinling. Through their hands and massage and some brain trains exercise, actually we can really mitigate the dementia.And this is one of the patients starting to learn to read the storybook. When read out the storybook, actually they are doing some stimulus to the brain and can activate the brain cell.We also have some outside activity, not only brain exercise and actually involve a physical exercise.
最年轻是20岁的慈科大的护理系的学生来当任志工。
好，所以从20岁到一。
So the activity involve 100 years old elder and the youngest volunteer 20 years old.
到我们的花莲慈济医院遇见作家深度展阅，介绍这一本。
Now get
里面的主角人物。
Online with director Zhang Xinling.Let's go to the Hualien Hospital. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
我打开简报，但是它出现主持人禁止与会者分享画面，所以是
好，我们马上处理哦。
那边打开一下，
好的 ，OK， 可以再一次吗？
可以吗？
您现在
好、
OK， 麻烦您。
我播放，嘿，我播放。
好的，好的，
稍等我一下。
Okay, we are solving some technical issue. Okay, finally, we are ready. Okay, let's give a round of applause to Director Zhang Xinling.
线上的听众们大家
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Xinling. Just now you have seen the video that we are involved in the community and some education about dementia. And today I would like to share a book.This book, when I joined Chiji Hospital in 90
中呢，我跟我的团队的各管师，我们集结了19位个案的一个。
We accumulate90 story and put into the book. We hope that to let the reader know about the dementia and acceptance of the dementia and then pay more attention to the issue of dementia.
大家有看到我 PPT 的第一章的左边有一个家族图，这是一个我在日照中心101岁的一个老妹奶奶，我们为她做的。
This is the grandmother's circuit at top. It's 100 years old.
所以我们呢，从这个生命故事书的历程，能够了解奶奶总共呢，她生了8位小孩。
Oh, she has 8 children, half of whom have passed away. So grandma has suffered from dementia for many years. And she still can walk with 4-leg walker. She still can take care of herself. Grandma is a very traditional Chinese woman. She came to daycare center 2 years ago. But she still can't remember my name. She only know me as a chief manager. She will speak to my the same sentence to me. Why you treat me so well? When eating, she will always say, I'll do it myself. You go and eat. And afraid I don't have a lunch. Sometimes he would say to me, I will share half of my meal with you. She doesn't have any different from the normal elder. But the children always accompany. So stay up at night and went to find her doctor in the middle of the night, or the sons die and need to go to funeral, and worry about the water was not married, and asked son to drop her to see a doctor. Sometimes he will often complain of being dizzy, patting his chest, and sometimes he will suddenly need to go home and say that the son is sick. I forgot she is in daycare. Sometimes she will say, I need to go to school, it's too late. Most of the grandma understand it's something that didn't happen in fact, but grandma believe it. These are the emotional and mental symptoms that normally were experienced. Sometimes the elder might need to wash hands for 20 minutes. Think about if you are a family caregiver, will you feel trouble? Not only not able to rest and sleep well at night.
So, some family caregivers
Most of the family caregiver will turn onto the doctor and send elder to the daycare. Sometimes they also ask the doctor to prescribe drug, hope to stabilize the symptom. But the effect cannot meet expectations. So you can feel what is a dementia and the the family caregiver. And there are 19 stories inside this book. How worse in the dementia in the world? 8% of people over age 65 suffer from dementia. It getting number increase when they get older. Actually, they do not understand what is dementia. They simply feel that getting older will inevitably lead to poor memory, brain degradation, which is sometimes we call or sometimes if people getting elder, they call old crazy symptom. Dementia is a sickness, it's not the elder problem. So sometimes it will cause delaying the timing of diagnosis and treatment. If we can identify it earlier, it will prevent the symptom get worse. The prevention and treatment of dementia is very important in the world. So you can see the chart, there's a 10th warning for dementia. So if there are more than 3 warning signs, we advise family members to take their elders to the hospital for medical evaluation. If we can diagnose and treat earlier, we can mitigate the symptom. Here is Mr. Li Fu Qiang, our meteorological expert in Taiwan. So depressed after losing his spouse, coupled with the impact of pandemic, he started to realize he had a precursor to dementia. So he went to the doctor and was diagnosed with mild dementia. And then use himself as an example to call the public to pay attention to the issue of dementia. Currently, the number of people with dementia in Taiwan has exceeded 300,000. On 90% of dementia elders are taken care of by family members at home. The older, the higher the rate of dementia. If we do not understand dementia enough, we cannot properly provide care and communication to dementia. Many family caregivers suffer from depression or even want to commit suicide with their demented family member. Therefore, the government launched the long-term care 2.0 service, which also includes dementia as a service project. In time, they already have the community care center for dementia, so it's very easy for people to access.
大家有看到简报上面的这位奶奶吗？她是我的外婆。
This is my grandmother.
And
that's also the reason why I need to write the book. When I was starting work as a nurse, I really do not understand what is dementia. My grandma is missing, and all our family take leave and come back to look for grandmother for 9 days and night. After searching for days and night, my grandmother was found, and she already passed away.
1991年的时候，护理部请我承接清安居的失智日间照护中心的护理长，然后也承接这个病房的一个。
It wasn't until I worked as a head nurse at senior home at Tsuji Hospital, then I came into the contact with elder with dementia, that I realized that my grandma must have been demented at the time.
那我慢慢的去领悟到，照顾失智症就好像是陪伴失智者。Caring
for a dementia person is like a long farewell ceremony.
照顾的长辈有长达十八年的，是吉安乡乡长的妈妈哈。Some
taking care like the range of 18 years.
所以随着病程的进展，失智长辈的身体功能会退化。
And the function of the body will degrade and forgot about their family, and they look very normal at peer. You can see this grandma doesn't want to wash the hair before she come to the day center. Before that, she actually not diagnosed as dementia, but when she behaved differently, the family brought her to the hospital and finally diagnosed as a dementia. Actually, grandma has an accident in the restroom. That's why she start to afraid to go to the restrooms. So when we care about the dementia patient, we need to know what is the history behind, and know their need. So when I realized that going to the restroom to wash the hair is so hard for this grandma, so I start to wash her hair in the dining room. That's why she feels so happy about that. And caring about the dementia can be a very happy job. She is not intent to make people trouble. Many dementia cases will have some inappropriate speech or behavior, saying that the family did not prepare food for him, or sometimes suddenly say that a family member has passed away, going to funeral, repeating things and words. Actually, those are symptoms of dementia. And During, you can see this grandma need to hold a doll, a baby toys to sleep. This grandma is 78 years old and husband's away when she was young. So she feel that children is very important for her life. So when during the lunch break, the daycare center will bring her the baby toys and the grandma will start to settle down. And you can see in the picture to understand what's the history behind of the patients. So in this book, we will describe the relationship between the dementia patients and their family and the important point. You can heart feel it when you see this picture. Although they are dementia, but their love is still there. Have you ever thought that one day you will be old, or maybe you are diagnosed as dementia? We're afraid of loneliness or abandoned by our family. When elder came to our daily center, they afraid family might abandon them, so they might some have experienced some emotional. So we need to create a caring environment so that they can feel comfortable. So we will create environment for them to live in a respectful life. You can see that 80 years old grandma will help 100 year grandpa to grab toilet paper, a tissue, and wash hands each other. A dementia grandma will comfort a Parkinson's grandpa. Or grandma will help feed a grandma with liver cancer. You can feel that although they are demented, their love will always be there. In the process of taking care of them, I've gained a lot. My biggest experience is the learning process and know what's the value of their assistance and take care of them. Hope that we can realize and take care of our elders. The elder also help daycare center, like clean up the floor. I hope that even they are elder, but they also should have the opportunity to live their life. Here are the self-care and mutual care in the community. Direct my mentor, Director Chai Shufeng, encouraged us to learn self-help, mutual help. And mutual help in community.
Yeah. 虽然是老化的国家，但是我们不孤单哦。那我们可以在这个过程当中学会一起运用社区的资源，然后提供长辈的资源。
We hope that we can use the resource from the community.
他们真正的一个需求，所以呢。
And know the need of the elder.
跟大家一起勉励的，那希望我们的社区可以充满爱。
I hope that our community can fill with love. I have served in Cizhou Hospital for 21 years and have been cared for Sigu and Sibo. And I don't see Sigu and Sibo getting older and some of them has dementia. And our daily center pledge that we can take care of these 四姑四伯 to repay back them. I may be old and I also may be demented, but I'm hoping to treasure the love of dementia and let everyone understand dementia and accept dementia, protect the demented elder.
那以上是我的分享，感恩大家的聆听。Thank
you. This is my sharing.
导播，我觉得我想要留在那个这一张简报，就是他从小到大的，蛮有感觉。哎，小时候就可以穿成这么漂亮，你那天是当伴娘。
This photo is my childhood to middle age.To show that,
其实哦，主任，他刚才讲话的那个速度，对我们口译团队来讲，一定非常的感动跟开心。而且他提供的是全程的逐字稿，我们给主任。
Yeah, thank you, Director Zhang Xinling. She provide me the full text that so that I can really translate more smoothly and clearly. Thank you so much.She just awarded the National Service Award. She need to leave earlier so that she have to taking care of the dementia elder later.
昆山长者的课程已经五年了，接感动满满，感恩满满，所以他直接在连线的当下来表达对您的感恩。泰国
的感恩心灵主任用爱。Someone in the daycare center, say thank you to the 张心灵 director.
为我们预习了老之将至，为自己也为家人预做准备。
A lot of good feedbacks to remind us that when we get old, we really need prepare and help each other.
我们高雄前镇区的一个温馨接送情的故事。那时金也说，我也不希望失智，所以现在就要开始不要忘记我是谁。加拿大的管心凌说，之前为了长辈开始失智问题，现在则是为了
sister and brothers, we should exercise our brain more harder and hope that we are not diagnosed by dementia, taking care of our brain.
张信麟大爱付出菩萨行，失智照护二十载吧，你写三十载，哎，主任你是二十哈，二十载哈，爱使长者乐开怀，如来家业肩上扛，荣获服务奉献奖，所以我们非常感恩，再次掌声感恩。
Thank you so much, 张信麟 director.
再见，谢谢您。
Thank you.
感恩感恩。我还有一点时间，所以我可以回去讲一下
I still have some time. Let me talk about the feedback.